Aman Wadud, thank you for being here.
Mr. Chairman and fellow commissioner, well, to understand what exactly is happening in India today, I think we need to understand what happened in Assam. In Assam, apart from the NRC, there is a parallel process of doubting citizenship. There are two so-called investigation agencies, Assam Border Police Organization, which has its presence all over the police station across Assam, and the Election Commission of India. Now, the border police job is to scan the area under this jurisdiction, and if they come across any citizen who do not have any paper, give them time. If they cannot provide papers, then accuse them of being illegal migrant. What happened actually on the ground is that they do not investigate any case, randomly accuse Indian citizens of being a foreigner. Example, Muhammad Sanaullah, an army officer who served India for 30 years, was accused of being illegal migrant, subsequently declared as foreigner. Muhammad Ajmal Haq, 30 years for... who served the Indian Army for 30 years, he was also accused of being an illegal migrant. After hue and cry, the case was dropped against him. Sanaullah was not that fortunate. Randomly, people, Indian citizens, are accused of being illegal migrant without any investigation whatsoever, violating the fundamental right to fair investigations. Another agency is the Election Commission of India. Since 1997, they started something called strict scrutiny of voter list. They mark people as devoter or doubtful voter, again, without any investigation whatsoever. Mostly, they have accused women of being a foreigner. Now, these cases goes to the Foreigners Tribunal for trial, a tribunal which the cases are adjudicated under the Foreigners Act 1946, a colonial act, where the burden of proof is on the accused. In any criminal case, the burden of proof is on the state. Here, if you're accused of being an illegal migrant without an investigation, the burden of proof is on you to prove that you are a citizen of India. Under the Foreigners Tribunal Order 1964, Foreigners Tribunal were created by executive order. All other tribunal in India is a creation of legislation. The Foreigners Tribunal, where the cases of citizenship is decided, is a creation of a executive order. Now, when the cases comes before the tribunal in Assam, one need to provide document before 25th March 1971, which is the cutoff date of citizenship in Assam. Now, ideally, what people does, they provide 1966 voter list and any document linking themselves with the 1966 voter list, say the father's documents or grandfather documents of 1966, or any document before 1971 and linking themselves with that voter list. Now, in the tribunal, most of the peoples are now declared as foreigner because of minor anomalies in their name and ages, which is very common to everyone. If any witness makes a minor contradictory statement, they can be stripped of citizenship because the burden of proof is on the accused. On July 2nd, 2019, the Home Ministry said in the Parliament that 63959 people were, 63,959 people were declared foreigner by ex parte order, which is more than 50%. Now, most of the people, they can't defend their citizenship. They can't afford lawyers. So when they can't afford lawyers, they stop going to the tribunal, and that's how many are declared as foreigner. One of them was Momiron Nessa. She was accused of being a illegal migrant, marked as devoter in 1997. She appeared before the tribunal, couldn't pay the lawyer. She was declared a foreigner by ex parte order. Subsequently, she was detained in 2010. She was detained till December 2019 for 9 years. When she was detained, her youngest son was 2 years old, and all three children were minors. She was separated from her children who were minors. And once you are declared as foreign, you can be detained in detention center. There are 6 detention centers in Assam. You can be detained there. The detainees do not have right to parole. Momiron Nessa's husband died when she was in detention. She was not allowed to come out of detention center because she did not have right to parole. She was allowed to come out of detention center because of Supreme Court order, which says that you cannot detain a person for more than 3 years, which is also, I think, is not justified because deportation is not possible. A person is detained to deport to the country of origin. Now, when you declare your own citizen as foreigner, you cannot deport that person. The Home Ministry says before the Parliament that since last 3 years, from 13-3-2013, since when the formal process of deportation started, only 4 people have been deported to Bangladesh. Within this period, 130,000 people have already been declared as foreigner. Now, once you are declared as foreigner, you do not have an appellate body. You'll have to go to the High Court and file a writ, where the Honorable High Court has very limited jurisdictions to decide the cases. Most of the cases, if a person is declared as foreigner, are upheld by the High Court because it has a certiorari jurisdiction, a supervisory jurisdiction, and not an appellate jurisdiction. Now, under such circumstances, you are stripped of citizenship, and then you become stateless. India disowns you, And Bangladesh will definitely own you because you are not a citizen of Bangladesh, you are a citizen of India. In that backdrop, the NRC was implemented because of the Supreme Court order 2014-15, the work started. According to the NRC rules, you need to prove that you are a descendant of a person who is in the territory of Assam before 25th March 1971. And you need to link with those documents. 5 years the process continued. I would say that the process was very harsh, stringent, technology driven. Although there was no religion column on it, but the Bengali Hindus and Muslims who are seen as a suspected citizen in Assam were the vulnerable group, mostly the Muslims, because of the anti-Muslim environment created by the government. Very often, Muslims are abused as Bangladeshis, even called as Jinnahs, who was the founder of Pakistan. The Muslims did not protest against the NRC. They rather participated in the NRC process because we all wanted a closure from this politicization, from this anti-Muslim rhetoric, from this rhetoric against illegal migrants, and from this stigmatization of being called as a suspect in your own beloved motherland. After the entire process, 1.9 million people were excluded, and most of them are Indian citizens, including my cousins who are excluded. His parents are included in the list. The process is inherently gender biased because women find very difficult to prove their citizenship because they get married before 18 years of age, and the minimum age to vote in India is 18. So you lose the important document called voter list, electoral roll. Your name is recorded in the voter list only after you get married, and that is at a matrimonial home with your husband, not your parents. So you lose the most important document to prove linkage with your parents. Now the government says they will scrap this NRC because it do not match with their propaganda that there are millions of illegal migrants here. There are no millions of illegal migrants in Assam. The NRC has exposed the propaganda of large-scale illegal migration into Assam. The current protest started after the current Home Minister said that first come the CAA, which is the Citizenship Amendment Act, which is discriminatory towards Muslims, which provide expedited citizenship for non-Muslim from three Muslim countries. And he said that then will come the NRC. Now, the legal foundation of the NRC is Citizenship Rule 2003. It says that there will be an NPR, National Population Register, and during the NPR process, your data will be collected, your particulars will be collected, your biometrics data, your parents' place of birth, their date of birth, their place of birth will be collected. And when the NRC is notified, the local register, which is the junior level executive officer, can mark any person as doubtful citizen. That is when you need to prove your citizenship. And then the citizenship rule also weaponizes fellow citizens of filing an objection against your citizenship. You will have to prove your citizenship then. Now, peoples in India are worried, particularly the Muslims, because they fear that something like Assam could happen, where even an army officer could be declared as foreigner, where Indian citizens are being rendered stateless and detained in detention center. That is why, the fear of losing citizenship forced people to protest, to come on the street, particularly women. Please go and ask those women who are protesting on the street. They will tell you that we do not want to go to detention center, and that is why we are protesting. The protest is not only against CAA, it is against the CAA, NPR, and NRC, which is a sinister design. Now, every time there is a peaceful protest in the BJP rule state, it has been crushed down by brutality, the police brutality. In UP, 20 Muslims were killed by bullet injuries. Police entered Muslims' homes, they beat them up without any provocation whatsoever. In Karnataka, a BJP rule state where a anti-CAA play was enacted by minor children, the mother was arrested for sedition charges. The principal of the school was arrested for sedition charges, that minor children were interrogated several times. In Delhi, where people were peacefully protesting on the street when Mr. Trump was visiting India, a BJP politician gave an ultimatum that if you cannot remove these people, we will hit the street. And that was the spark of the violence. The mob started attacking mostly Muslims, and the police did not stop the mob. Rather, they participated in the violence. There is an abdication of responsibility on the part of the police. No FIR was lost against the persons who sparked this violence. Even lawyers who went to police stations were beaten up. The fear among Muslims today is genuine. The fear to leave the fear of losing citizenship is genuine because they know if NRC is implemented, they will be asked to prove their citizenship. It is almost, you know, if the parameter of Assam is used all over India, hardly anyone will prove their citizenship. To prove a citizenship, you need to provide document. The Citizenship Act 3A says that any person born in India from 26 January 1950, which is the commencement of the constitution, to 1st of July 1987 is an Indian by birth. So basically, the jus soli concept principle is applied during that period. You need to prove that you are born in India before 1st of July 1987. How do you prove you are born in India? You need a birth certificate. Most of the people do not have birth certificate. This peaceful, non-violent protest is to live a dignified life which is guaranteed by this great document called the Indian Constitution, an unparalleled document in the history of modern nation. This guarantees to live a dignified life. The entire protest is to live a dignified life. Thank you so much.